They make the world of sci-fi sexy. From the mythical series Legend of the Seeker, please welcome Craig Horner and Bridget Regan. Thanks so much for coming in today.
Thanks for having us.
Well, I want to congratulate you guys on the second season of the show.
Thank you.
So tell me, has life changed for either of you since the show began?
We're just talking about that, right?
Totally. Everything's changed, nearly.
Yeah. What for you exactly?
Bridget's got a cat, a dog, everything.
Yeah, I used to live in New York, and now I'm home in New Zealand, and we go out into the woods every day and fight and play and run around and play silly buggers, as Craig says.
That's great. And Craig, now you're from Australia, so how has this changed your life being New Zealand?
It's not that far, really. Okay. It's like a three-hour flight, but, I mean, you know, it's still two very different kind of cultures. And there's always a bit of fun little rivalry that's been going on between Aussies and Kiwis. All in good fun. Only when it comes to sport and stuff like that.
Uh-huh. But, I sometimes tease him a bit on stage.
Yeah, that's okay.
Oh, I love your guys.
I wouldn't take it if I don't dish it, so it's all right.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
All right, now, Bridget, I heard there was a little bit of a language barrier for you when you arrived.
Oh, totally. I mean, I couldn't understand some things. Well, the Kiwi accent's really funny. I don't know if you've seen, like, Flight of the
Conchords,
things like that. And they would say things, and I would just kind of smile and nod and not completely understand.
Give me an example.
Oh, gosh, well...
Aluminium?
Oh,
aluminium, and that means what?
Aluminum!
How are we supposed to know that?
I don't know! I'm going, what? What are you talking about? Yeah, but it happens often, but now I can dish it out and, you know...
Cool.
Well, hang with the Kiwis.
That's what you gotta do. People don't know much about the show, haven't seen it yet. Why don't you give us, I guess, a little description of the show, and we're gonna show a clip, so you wanna set that up?
Yeah, I think the clip you're gonna see, Charisma Carpenter, one of our guest actresses from the Buffy and Angel kind of series. We were lucky enough to have her, and this is a scene. She plays a Maud Sith, and she has left Kara, another Maud Sith, for dead. And I find Kara, and I kind of want to give her a second.
Not sure if that's a scene we have.
Oh, it's not?
Wait, let's take a look. Go ahead. Let's see. Surprise us.
What children?
Girls your sisters took from Arengard.
If any girls were taken, my sisters must have done it after they beat me and left me to die.
I'll get the truth out of her.
You can tell she's lying?
Their training makes the Maud Sith hard to read, but I'll find out.
She's the one who helped me kill Darkin Rahl.
Whatever she did it to save her own skin. Richard, we can't trust her.
I'm not telling you to trust her. I'm telling you to trust me.
All right, for the record, that was the clip. That's a good thing.
Yeah.
But I have to ask about this on-screen romance. I see some sexual tension between the two of you.
Yeah.
But it's true that, you know, you cannot, I guess, basically have sex or you lose your powers. Is that true?
Well, to put it lightly.
Yeah.
yeah, we have one of those sort of relationships, those epic, you know,
forbidden love.
That's right. Yeah, so it's a bit timeless in that way.
And what are your powers on the show?
Oh, well, I can tell if someone's telling the truth or not, which is quite convenient. I have the ability to touch a man and have him become completely enamored with me.
Which is something that every girl would love to have. And
I think most girls do have that.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. That's a benefit. And what about you? What powers do you have?
Well, I'm the Seeker, but Richard doesn't even really know.
Do you have some powers that we know?
He's kind of finding that out as he goes. I mean, the one thing he was really opposed to in the first kind of when the season started was magic. And as the season progresses, he's finding out that he is actually a very powerful wizard with magic. So he's kind of embracing that.
Good. Well, thank you guys so much for coming in. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
The two-hour season premiere of The Legend of the Seeker premieres this Saturday at 4 p.m. right here on PIX. And don't forget to check them out in Times Square today at 10:30.
Yeah.
You can go meet them. All right, let's head back to the desk.